हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू विजन सक्सेस। गाइस, टॉप 10 क्वेश्चंस फॉर यूपीएससी प्रीलिम्स लेकर मैं वापस आया हूँ आप लोगों के समक्ष। आप लोगों के कमेंट्स, मैंने जैसा कहा था कि आप लोग अगर कमेंट करोगे तो मैं आप लोगों के कमेंट्स को वीडियो में लूंगा, तो वीडियो के लास्ट में आप लोगों के कमेंट्स हैं, जाके जरूर देखिएगा। जिन लोगों ने ये कहा था सर क्वेश्चन के नंबर इंक्रीज कीजिए, तो मैं क्वेश्चन के नंबर इंक्रीज क्यों, बट आप लोग कमेंट बॉक्स में जाकर बताओ तो सही कि आप लोगों के कितने क्वेश्चन गलत हुए, कितने क्वेश्चन सही हुए। ये चीजें काफी ज्यादा जरूरी है आप लोगों के लिए, ठीक है। तो बी एक्टिव, ठीक है, और चलिए स्टार्ट करते हैं। फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज कंसीडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स अबाउट द नेचर ऑफ द ओशियन करेंट्स। फर्स्ट स्टेटमेंट, देयर इज नो वेस्ट विंड ड्रिफ्ट करेंट इन द इंडियन ओशियन। सेकेंड स्टेटमेंट, द ईस्टवर्ड फ्लो ऑफ द इक्वेटोरियल काउंटर करेंट इज ड्यू टू the difference in the salinity of the water. Third statement, Mozambique current and West Australian current are warm currents. Which of the statements given above are correct? So here is your options. Choose the correct option. Okay. Answer आपका है D. First question का answer है D. The eastward flow of the equatorial current काउंटर करेंट इज रिलेटेड टू द कन्वर्जेंस ऑफ द टू इक्वेटोरियल करेंट्स। कन्वर्जेंस रेजेस द लेवल ऑफ ओशियन इन द वेस्टर्न पार्ट्स बाय फ्यू सेंटीमीटर्स व्हिच क्रिएट्स एन इक्वेटोरियल काउंटर करेंट। हेंस स्टेटमेंट सेकेंड इज नॉट करेक्ट। द वेस्ट ऑस्ट्रेलियन करेंट इज अ कूल सर्फेस करेंट ऑफ द सदर्न इंडियन ओशियन। इट स्टार्ट्स एज द सदर्न इंडियन ओशियन करेंट, a part of the largest Antarctic circumpolar current, also known as the west wind drift. As the current approaches western Australia, it turns north parallel to the western coast of Australia and becomes the west Australian current. Hence, statement first and third is not correct. One branch of the southern Indian equatorial current moves southward through Mozambique Channel, known as Mozambique current. It is a warm current. Okay. So guys, first question ka D option correct hai. And move on next question. In the context of the developments in the field of biochemistry, the term interferons, sometimes seen in the news, refers to. Here is your options. Choose the correct option, guys, because it is important question. तो क्वेश्चन सेकंड का ऑप्शन बी करेक्ट है। इंटरफेरेंस आर प्रोटीन्स दैट आर प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय द बॉडीज सेल्स एज अ डिफेंसिव रिस्पांस टू वायरसेस। दे आर इंपॉर्टेंट मॉड्यूलेटर्स ऑफ द इम्यून रिस्पांस। इंटरफेरॉन वाज नेम्ड फॉर इट्स एबिलिटी टू इंटरफेयर विथ वायरल प्रोलिफरेशन। इंटरफेरेंस कैन आल्सो कॉम्बैट bacterial and parasitic infections, inhibit cell division and promote or impede the differentiation of cells. They are produced by all vertebrate animals and possibly by some invertebrate as well. Okay. Next question is, consider the following statement with reference to the presiding officers of the House of the Parliament. First statement is, the presiding officers summon their respective houses from time to time. Second statement, the chairman of the Rajya Sabha and the speaker of the Lok Sabha are the leaders of their respective houses. Third statement, the chairman of the Rajya Sabha is the ex officio chairman of the Indian parliamentary group. So here is your options. Choose the correct option, guys, and comment in the comment box. Okay. थर्ड क्वेश्चन का आपका करेक्ट ऑप्शन है डी। द स्पीकर इज द हेड ऑफ द लोकसभा एंड इट्स रिप्रेजेंटेटिव। अंडर द रूल्स ऑफ लोकसभा, लीडर ऑफ द हाउस मींस द प्राइम मिनिस्टर। इफ ही इज अ मेंबर ऑफ लोकसभा और अ मिनिस्टर हु इज अ मेंबर ऑफ लोकसभा एंड इज नॉमिनेटेड बाय द प्राइम मिनिस्टर टू द फंक्शन एज द लीडर ऑफ द हाउस, देयर इज ऑल्सो अ लीडर ऑफ the house in the Rajya Sabha. He is a minister and a member of the Rajya Sabha and is nominated by the Prime Minister to the function as such. Hence, statement is second is not correct. Okay. Next point is the speaker of the Lok Sabha acts as the ex officio chairman of the Indian parliamentary group, which acts as a link between the parliament of India and the various parliaments of the world. He also acts as the ex officio chairman of the conference of presiding officers of legislative bodies in the country. Hence, statement third is not correct, guys. Summoning. What is summoning? The president of India from time to time summons each house of parliament to meet. But the maximum gap between two sessions of parliament cannot be more than 6 months. In other words, the parliament should meet at least twice a year. Hence, statement first is not correct. Okay. So, move on next question, guys. In India, uniform recall period URP and mixed recall period MRP are associated with for what? Okay. So, guys, here is your option. Choose correct option. Okay. So, fourth question ka aapka correct answer hai B. According to the World Bank, poverty is pronounced deprivation in well-being. In India, Planning Commission used to estimate the number and proportion of people living below the poverty line at national and state levels separately for rural and urban area. Okay, poverty estimates based on a large sample survey of household consumption expenditure carried out by the National Sample Survey Organization, जिसे हम लोग NSSO कहते हैं, ठीक है? After an interval of approximately 5 years, the commission has been estimating the poverty line and poverty ratio since 1997 on the basis of the methodology spelled out in Lakhadwala Committee report. In India, there are two methods of poverty estimation, namely uniform recall period and mixed recall period. Up until 1993 to 1994, the poverty line was based on URP data. In URP, consumer expenditure data for all the items are collected for a 30-day recall period. Since 1999 to 2000, however, data are being collected according to MRP. In MRP, consumer expenditure data for 5 non-food items, namely clothing, footwear, durable goods, education and institutional medical expenses are collected for a 365 days. Recall period and the consumption data for the remaining items are collected for a 30 days recall period. So guys, here is question 4 is completed and move on next question. What is it? Which of the following statement is correct about Operation Clean Art? So, what is Operation Clean Art? So, here is your option. Choose the correct option. I hope you choose the correct option. Okay. So, what is Operation Art? Operation Clean Art. Operation Clean Art was the first pan-India operation to crack down on the smuggling of mongoose hair in the country. It was conceived by WCCB, Wildlife Crime Control Bureau, with the singular aim of ensuring that the mongoose hairbrush trade should be closed down across the country. What is WCCB? WCCB is the statutory multidisciplinary body under the Union Minister of Environment, Forests and Climate Change to combat organized wildlife crime in the country. Okay, so next question is, what is it? Which of the following statement are correct regarding Bank Board Bureau, triple B? First statement is, it is an autonomous body established based on the recommendations of the Nachiket Moore Committee. Next point is, functions of the board include helping banks in terms of developing business strategies and capital raising plans. Third option is, third statement is, it is responsible for the selection and appointment of the board of directors of both public and private sector banks. क्वेश्चन 6 का ऑप्शन ए सही है, ठीक है, ए ऑप्शन करेक्ट है, ओके। द बैंक बोर्ड ब्यूरो हैज इट्स जेनेसिस इन द रिकमेंडेशंस ऑफ द कमेटी टू रिव्यू गवर्नेंस ऑफ बोर्ड्स ऑफ बैंक इन इंडिया आल्सो नोन एज पीजे नायक कमेटी मई 2014। हेंस स्टेटमेंट फर्स्ट इज नॉट करेक्ट। नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज फंक्शन ऑफ द बैंक बोर्ड ब्यूरो टू बी रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द सिलेक्शन एंड अपॉइंटमेंट ऑफ द बोर्ड ऑफ डायरेक्टर्स इन पब्लिक सेक्टर बैंक एंड FIIs। हेंस स्टेटमेंट थर्ड इज नॉट करेक्ट। एंड नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज टू एडवाइज द गवर्नमेंट ऑन इवॉल्विंग सुस्टेबल ट्रेनिंग एंड डेवलपमेंट प्रोग्राम फॉर मैनेजमेंट पर्सनल PSBs, FIIs to help banks in terms of developing business strategies and capital raising plans, etc. So, hence statement second is correct. So, it is the function of bank board bureau and some other is like to advise the government on matters relating to appointments, confirmation or extension of tenure and termination of services of the board of directors of the above mentioned levels to advise the government on the desired structure at the board level and for senior management personnel for each PSB and FI. And other is to help banks to develop the robust leadership succession plan for critical position that would arise in the future through appropriate HR process including performance management systems. So guys, here 6th question is completed. Next question is, which of the following statements are correct regarding the Advertising Standards Council of India, ASCI? So first is, it is a regulatory body established by the government by executive order. Second statement is, the rules formulated by the body for advertisement norms are binding in nature. So, choose the correct option, guys. It is very important for you. Okay. So, guys, question 7th ka correct answer hai D. Okay. The Advertising and Standards Council of India, established in 1985, is a voluntary self-regulatory council registered as a not-for-profit company under Section 25 of the Indian Companies Act with the objective of ensuring that all advertising should be legal, decent, honest and truthful along with a sense of social responsibility to the consumer and to the rules of fair competition. Hence, statement first is not correct. And other is, the ASCI is not government body, nor does it formulate rules for the public or for the relevant industries. It has adopted a code for self-regulation in advertising. It is a commitment to honest advertising and to fair competition in the marketplace. It stands for the protection of the legitimate interests of consumers and all concerned with advertising. Advertisers, media, advertising agencies and others who help in the creation or placement of advertisement. Hence, statement second is not correct. Okay. Guys, ASCI was formed with the support of all four sectors connected with advertising, with advertisers, advertising agencies, media, and other like PR agencies, market research company, etc. ASCI seek to ensure the advertisements conform to its code for self-regulation. Okay, so move on next question. What is it? It is, consider the following statement with the reference to procedure related to voting on demands for grant in the parliament. Dekhte hain kiska sahi hota hai ye question. First is, the voting is the exclusive privilege of the Lok Sabha. Second is, the expenditure charge upon the consolidated fund of the India is neither subject to voting nor can be discussed. So, here is your option. Choose the correct option, guys. It is very important for you. So voting on demands for grant is the fourth stage in the enactment of the budget. The Lok Sabha takes up the voting of demands for grants. The demands are presented ministry wise. A demand becomes a grant after it has been duly voted. The voting of demands for grants is exclusive privilege of the Lok Sabha. That is, the Rajya Sabha has no power of voting the demands. Second, the voting is confined to the votable part of the budget. The expenditure charged on the consolidated fund of India is not submitted to the vote. As the statement first is correct and second is not correct. Okay. So move on next question. What is it? Which of the following statement are correct with reference to Rahnumai Maz Dayasan Sabha? First statement, the Sabha was against the social reforms in the field of women empowerment. Second is, it was founded by the Dada Bhai Naroji and others. And third is, Rasht Goftar was an important newspaper that propagated the message of this association. So here is your option. Choose the correct option, guys. So guys, statement second is correct. Rahnumai Maz Dayasan Sabha, a religious reform association, was founded by the Dada Bhai Naroji, Naroji Fardunji and SS Bengali in 1851. The objective of the association was the regeneration of the social condition of the Parsi community and restoration of the Zoroastrian religion to its pristine purity. Statement first is not correct because the Sabha had focused on the improvement of the condition of Parsi women and propagated for removal of the Purda system and raising the age of marriage among women and the education of women. Statement third is correct because the newspaper Rasht Goftar, a Gujarati fortnightly, was an important newspaper that propagated the message of this association. It was founded by the Dada Bhai Naroji in 1851 to clarify Zoroastrian concepts and promote Parsi social reforms. So guys, aapka ninth question complete hua yahan pe. Move on next question. Which of the following reflects constitutionalism in the Indian polity? So it is very important for you. Choose the correct option, guys. So 10th question ka guys, correct option is C. Constitutionalism has variety of meanings. Most generally, it is a complex of ideas, attitudes and patterns of behavior elaborating the principle that the authority of government derives from and is limited by a government of fundamental law. Constitutionalism means limited government or limitation on government. It is the antithesis of arbitrary powers. Constitutionalism recognizes the need for a government with powers, but at the same time insists the limitation be placed on those powers. The antithesis of constitutionalism is despotism. A government that goes beyond its limits loses its authority and legitimacy. Okay. So guys, I hope you understand. And constitutionalism could be seen as the constituting the some elements like government according to the constitution, separation of power, sovereignty of the people, and democratic government, constitutional review, independent judiciary, limited government subject to a bill of individual rights, controlling the police, civilian control of the military, and no state power or very limited and strictly circumscribed state power to suspend the operation of some parts of the entire constitution. So guys, I hope you understand the top 10 questions for UPSC prelims 2020. So if you like this video and if it is helpful for your prelims, so like this video, कमेंट व्हाट इज योर सजेशन एंड कमेंट व्हाट इज योर मार्क्स एंड शेयर इट विथ योर फ्रेंड्स एंड इन योर स्टडी ग्रुप्स गाइस एंड इफ यू आर कमिंग हियर फर्स्ट टाइम सो सब्सक्राइब द चैनल थैंक यू सो मच बेस्ट ऑफ लक